Virtual work method is derived from the principle of conservation of energy, where the external work done by the exerted forces is balanced by the internal work done. In this video, we will look into the implementation of virtual work method in calculating a beam deflection in 6 steps. We will be using a simply supported beam subjected to uniformly distributed load with increasing intensity here. First, we need to determine the support reaction. The uniformly distributed load is converted to equivalent concentrated load. Based on its lever arm from our reference point A, the support reaction at A and B are determined using equilibrium equations. This step is essential to prepare us for the next step. We are now entering step 2, which is deriving the internal moment function. Let's set point A as our reference point for x. As x increases, the intensity of load increases linearly. Therefore, we are good to describe the change in internal moment using only one function. For step 3, we need to conduct it according to our M of analysis. If we need to determine the displacement at one point, we will put a virtual concentrated load on it. If you want to determine the rotation instead, we will put a virtual moment. From previous video, we know the maximum displacement occurs at 0.519L from support A. Now, let's put our virtual load here and see if we can get the same answer in the end. For step 4, we need to determine the beam support reaction when it is subjected to the virtual load. As mentioned previously, this is our prerequisite to define the internal moment function. Next, let's determine the internal moment function as usual. After that, we are entering the last step of virtual work method. First, we need to substitute the internal moment functions into this equation. Then, we solve it with the limit from 0 to L, attempting to determine the internal work done by the beam. The final answer obtained from the integration is the displacement at the point we set in step 3. Feel free to pause this video and study the procedure. When the value is positive, it means the direction of displacement is the same as the direction of virtual load. What should we do if we want to determine the rotation at point A? Since we already determined the internal moment function under actual loading condition, we can skip to step 3 directly. In this step, we apply a unit virtual moment at point A. Then, we proceed to determine the support reactions and internal moment function under this loading condition. Again, we substitute the moment functions into the equation. By solving it, we get to know the rotation at point A. Since the sign of the answer is negative, it means the beam is rotating in the opposite direction of virtual moment, which is clockwise direction. Thank you for watching. If you find this video helpful, please share it with your friends. We'll see you guys soon. Goodbye.